What's up, music nerds? So following the release of the acoustic version of Modsun and Avril Lavigne's song Flames, I thought it would be a really fun idea to try and break down some of the compositional arrangement and production aspects of the original song. And I will say to anyone who's skeptical that any modern music can actually have thought and talent put into it, I would argue that this is probably one of the most skillfully written pieces of music that I've heard in quite some time. So anyways, without further ado, let's get into the song. So this song essentially starts out with a very simple melody. It's just Avril Lavigne's vocals over the piano part, and it's a very simple chord progression, but the note choices that they chose over it are what actually makes it interesting. So the piano and acoustic guitar in this part, the song is in C minor, so they're playing a simple progression of C minor to E flat to B flat to A flat. Over these chords, what they did was really interesting in the way that they rarely ever linger on the root note of the chord, and I'll explain what I'm talking about here. So basically, the main notes they fall on over this C minor chord are G and E flat. Once we move up to the actual E flat chord, we move even higher up to the B flat, A flat, to G. Now I'm going to talk a little bit about chord motion in this. So basically, in our case of this song, C minor is basically a moving chord, which basically means it wants to resolve to something. Then we get to E flat, which basically sounds more resolved, and therefore you want to pick more notes that really fit well in there. Making a perfect progression down to the third of the chord is a really nice choice. So the next half of this part basically just goes B flat to A flat. Now, in this case, B flat is the moving chord and A flat is the sort of stagnant chord. In terms of the melody that's going on here, they add in this D flat over that chord to kind of add a little bit of tension to move into the next chord, which feels much more resolved. The melody over this is basically just a standard F, G, F, E flat. And then that transitions perfectly back into the C. So then they'll basically repeat that melody over again, and then that will bring us into the first verse section. So I want to talk drums a little bit during this section. So Modsun has actually put out an entire video where he basically breaks down everything that he did in the drums and why he did that. So I will leave that linked in the description if you guys want to check that out. But basically the main idea that he goes for is everything you do has to benefit the song. What's happening a lot here in the drums is he's using the kick as sort of a means to emphasize the entry of a new section. Let me show you what I'm kind of talking about here. I'm not sure if my amateur drumming skills did it any justice, but hopefully you were able to notice that there are certain parts where the kick notes and also the ghost notes on the snare kind of lined up with what was going on as the song was kind of progressing, whether it lines up with like a chord change or a vocal line. Another thing I'd like to take note of in this song is they actually did a really, really good job blending the sort of sampled drum sound with the actual like real drum sound. And I think that's something that is really happening a lot more in modern music today between artists like Machine Gun Kelly, Youngblood, and various others. While we're on the topic of chord progressions, I want you to actually notice that this chord progression actually moves fairly significantly faster than most I've heard. So basically the progression goes C minor, E flat, B flat, A flat, C minor, B flat, A flat, G. Now both the C and E flat, both times around, only last for about a dotted quarter note. Let's hear it along with the song. Now, admittedly, it is a little bit tough to hear this clean guitar part in the background, but it sounds to me like what he's basically going is basically going along with the bass notes, but he's also adding in this open G string. They're kind of just droning over the same note, but it works really well over all of the chords. Let's see how it actually sounds me playing it. If you think about it, it actually almost sounds kind of slightly Metallica influenced by some of their more ballad type work, especially when you slow it down like I just did. And you'll notice that in the vocals, they feel fairly close to the E flat major chord over all of these, and there's no point at which it doesn't work for any of them. So for the first time around, he's basically just going A flat to G, and it works the same way over all of the chords. Let's take a listen to the first verse played over all the chords. So at this point, they basically transition to a different melody. Mazzan actually takes his vocals down an octave, which adds a lot of contrast between the two verses. There's also an octave harmony, which kind of gives you a little bit of sense of familiarity with what was going on before. Let's hear how this part goes over these chords. Every time I think I had enough of this, I get more addicted, yeah, I'm so upset. So over this progression, he's singing in an E flat chord, which gives a nice harmonic contrast especially over the A flat, because that has the major seventh in it. At this point in the song, the drums actually get a much more relaxed feel to kind of match the feel that was given to it by the vocals. So essentially what changes about this, we have closed hi-hat rather than open, and there are a few less kick hits. So basically, there's just like subtle little changes that give it a more relaxed feel. There's that like one open hi-hat hit that kind of gives it a nice little vibe to it. And obviously, they kind of like cut the frequency of the kick hits in half. Kind of makes it feel a little bit more open. So after this, we're going to basically go into the chorus. One of the things Mazzan talked about in his original drum lesson for this is that essentially, one of the things he was trying to go for in this song was having every chorus sound different, which is very different from most music, because a lot of times you want every single chorus to sound the same, so it develops a sense of familiarity. But what he actually does in the drums during this chorus is rather a lot different from what Avril did in the original version of the chorus. So essentially, Mazzan at this point in the second chorus, basically what he's gonna do is add a little extra phrase to the chorus that kind of brings it a little closer to the resolution, which I think makes the second chorus sound a little bit more interesting than the first, and it helps draw in the listener's attention more as the song moves forward. So essentially, Avril's version of the chorus only includes, I still burn for you, like the sun burns in the sky, I still burn for you. Pardon my vocal abilities or lack thereof, but essentially what Mazzan is adding to this, he's adding a nice little walk down an F minor scale over the B flat and A flat. So it sounds like, burn for you, burn for you. And it adds a really nice contrast to the chorus, because basically you'll notice that Avril Lavigne's voice actually has a really clean and clear tone, whereas Mazzan's voice is a little bit more gritty in this particular track, at least in comparison to Avril's. So after the first cycle through the chorus, they basically go back through it again with the two of their voices combined together, which adds a really unique sound, because obviously the two sing in a very similar range over the course of this track, but the tones in their voices are so different that it kind of just adds to the atmosphere of it. Now also at this point in the chorus, they add an interesting little drum part, and it's essentially just a regular roll over some basic kick stuff. I would play the whole thing for you, but my beginning drummer brain can't handle it, so I'll play you each individual part. So essentially the snare is just doing a basic roll like this, while at the same time the kick is going. So at this point, we actually have another guitar instrument that's introduced with a lot of heavy reverb. Now we'll go play that for you in a second, but essentially that part is going to carry us until the next chorus. So this guitar that enters is basically, it's essentially a really country-like tone with a lot of reverb to kind of give a little bit of ambience and space to the track. Let me play essentially what's going on along with the song for you. This guitar part will also be reintroduced back into the third verse as well. So let me play that for you. So you can see it's not a very major part, but it kind of adds in a little bit of ambience to fill up the extra space. Now let's also talk about what's going on in the vocal parts here. So during this verse, Avril Lavigne essentially just repeats a couple of the lines that Maud Sun says, essentially similar to the way he did in the chorus when she was singing, and then it ends with a unison line between the two of them, which will lead us into the next chorus. So we're now to the final chorus, and this is where I feel like all of the major energy to the track really comes from. So this part is introduced with a nice little palm muted guitar part. Let me play it along with the song for you. Now this is where the drums essentially bring the last blast of energy to the track, and this is the only real part where I feel like he brings in the crash cymbal in a really major way. So it just brings a lot of impact to the drum sound overall and brings the energy that they kind of need to bring the track to a climax. After this, there's one more major change up in the drums before the kind of ending of the song. So let me play that for you. And basically what it is, it kind of feels like it's getting faster, but almost building tension at the same time, which helps to bring the song to sort of an ending of sorts. So let me just say, this was definitely the most difficult part for me to learn on the drums, because the first snare hit of each measure actually goes on the and of two rather than on two like we would normally think of it. So it's a little bit tricky to think about, but it adds a little bit of tension to the song that kind of pulls it together at the end. So for the ending of the song, it's basically a dual vocal between both Maud Sun and Avril Lavigne at the same time. And additionally, during this final chorus, there's a guitar part that comes in that kind of basically just drones over a few notes to add a little bit more ambience to the ending of this track. Then basically everything starts to drop out, and you basically just have the rap hip hop style instrumentation over Maud Sun's vocals. And then all of that drops out, and it's just piano and acoustic guitar with Avril Lavigne's vocals again, just the same as the intro. It's a really, really nice way to end it after all the energy that it brought at the very end there. Anyways, guys, I had a lot of fun doing this breakdown of this song for you, and it's definitely a different video from what I'm used to making, so if you enjoy this style of video, be sure to let me know in the comments section. Be sure to let me know if there's anything I missed about the song that you would like to me have said, and as always, be sure to give it a like if you enjoyed the video, and if you're new, maybe consider subscribing to the channel. But that's all for now, and I will see you guys next time.